Here we are again, another Olympics during the pandemic. What are you thinking about?
The timing couldn't be much worse. That being said, I'm looking forward to watching it, but I'm nervous.
Hennepin Healthcare Dr. David Hilden is a big fan of the Olympics. He can't wait to see the world's best athletes compete in the Winter Games. But from a public health perspective,
it's an awful idea to hold the Olympics. That's really the last thing you would want to do. But there's another side to that. There's the human interaction point of view, and there is the need to get on with a life that is meaningful and full of joy for people.
According to the Beijing Winter Olympic Organizing Committee, athletes will be tested for COVID-19 two times a day. They will live and eat separately from all other athletes and will have special vehicles that will bring them from their hotel to their event. Athletes who test positive for COVID-19 will either be sent to a special hospital or an isolation facility, depending on if they're showing symptoms, and they will need two negative COVID tests within 24 hours to be cleared for competition.
Given that the Winter Olympics are largely outdoor events, not entirely, but largely, I think it's possible to do these with a relative degree of safety.
We did have an Olympics not too long ago in the Summer Olympics. What did we see and what did we possibly learn?
I think what they realize is that it can be done relatively safely, but nothing can be done completely safely.
A new report from the International Olympic Committee shows, yes, athletes did get sick with COVID-19 during the Tokyo Summer Games, but cases were few and far between. Of 11,300 athletes between the Olympics and Paralympics, 33 tested positive for COVID-19 during the Games. Out of tens of thousands of workers, journalists, and volunteers, 464 tested positive. And according to the report, none of these cases spread outside of the Olympic bubble. But Dr. Hilden says there's always a risk that something could happen.
Literally every athlete from a different country, every visitor from a different place is a new variable.
And he says China hasn't exactly been transparent when it comes to COVID. Chinese officials have kept a lot of information and data secret from the international community. But the Chinese government has a lot riding on the Games, so he wouldn't be surprised to see them clamp down extra hard to keep athletes safe.
What do you think viewers should expect to see during the Games?
Uncertainty has become our daily reality. And so I am going to watch the Olympics. I'm going to watch a lot of it because I like it and it brings me joy. But you can't get set on any particular athlete. That person might be out. You can't get set on any particular event happening. You just have to sort of roll with the punches. I think it's really important that we just be flexible and enjoy whatever we do get to see.
And speaking of rolling with the punches, we still don't know who will be on the U.S. men's hockey team this year after the NHL decided to drop out of the Olympics. The selection committee is now looking for the top amateur hockey players to fill out their roster. The committee has chosen a new coach and general manager, but players still haven't been announced. Of course, if anything changes with the Games due to the pandemic or anything else, we'll have the latest. KARE 11's the home of the Winter Olympics. You can watch it, all the action here. Our coverage starts February 3rd with the opening ceremony on February 4th. The Games go through February 20th.